Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market preparation video for January 15th, 2021. Well, yesterday we had a little bit of back and forth in the market. We were bullish for a little bit, and then we kind of slipped a little bit. Kind of an interesting day. But what does that mean for today? Well, how about we grab ourselves something to drink, settle in, and let's get ready for the Friday edition to the Morning Market Prep video. This morning, everyone, we have kind of an interesting day setting up. I want to remind everyone that Monday, the market is closed. This coming Monday, market is closed for Martin Luther King Day. So we have a three-day weekend and a short week next week to kind of keep in mind. We also have kind of an interesting situation, in the sense that we heard from President-elect Biden a $1.9 trillion addition to the stimulus is what he's proposing, plus several other things out there on the way. And we also have the inauguration of President-elect Biden next week. So we'll want to kind of keep that in mind, as well as just the ramp up for earnings. We're going to start ramping up pretty strongly in those earnings reports next week. A lot more coming down the pipeline that could create some volatility. So we're going to have to stay on our toes, and we want to be thinking about those things as we kind of plan into this longer weekend. Let's take a look at the technicals of the chart. If we take a look here, you can see that we continue to remain in a bullish trend. And yesterday we had the Dow pushed up to a new record high, but unfortunately yesterday it wasn't quite able to hold on to that. And this morning we're seeing just a tiny little bit of bearishness. Honestly, kind of surprising to me that we're taking such a ho-hum attitude to another 1.9 trillion. And in fact, there is a story out there that I saw that this 1.9 trillion could actually pop the bubble of this rally. I don't know, we'll see. But right now, if we take a look at the technicals of the chart, we're still bullish. And even though it is certainly pulling back this morning, let's just take note, if we were to draw a little box right around this area, we're still in a consolidation in the Dow. Now, keep in mind, it is pretty darn painful, and I've mentioned this several times before, it could be pretty darn painful just pulling back into these levels of support, because it looks like it's just right there, but these are several hundred point moves to move us down into these price support levels. And if we were to fail that trend and break down into here, headed back toward that 50-day moving average, we're looking at better than 1,000 points in that potential move. So if that selling wave does start to pick up, we'll want to keep in mind how painful that might be. However, I wouldn't want to be predicting that in any way, shape, or form. And the reason is because we do have these support levels in here, and we have that trend to work with. So we could bounce off of any of these places and still be perfectly fine in the market. A little rest, a little pullback, not that big a deal. And particularly heading into a three-day weekend with uncertainties out there, could be a reason to just take some profits. Let's take a look at the SPY, SPY. Very much the same situation. We tried to push up yesterday, didn't quite make it out there to that new record, and ended up with a little bit of a bearish engulfing candle here. Now, I say bearish engulfing candle, but I want to continue to point out that really all we're doing is consolidating. Notice we're just consolidating in this level. I wouldn't put a whole lot of weight into that bearish engulfing candle, unless we had a follow-through today that would happen to break that support. Then we've got a little bit of concern. But as long as we can hold on to this trend, I think we're going to be okay. If we pull back into here, probably no harm, no foul, if those bulls can pick up and defend and push us right back up. So watch that closely. We're only going to really, I think, start showing some technical damage here in this chart if we break that trend. So watch that. Now, albeit that could be a rather painful pullback if that were to occur. Let's take a look at the NASDAQ, QQQ. QQQ, a little bit more of a concern. Right now, I'm kind of thinking that the NASDAQ is the weakest of the indexes right now. It's not terribly bad. There's nothing wrong here. But notice we've just kind of struggled in here a little bit more. And we continue to get these attacks against big tech. Yesterday, we heard of another lawsuit on the big techs going against Amazon. And we've seen Facebook and Twitter and those kind of things selling off pretty hard. Watch that closely. We could see if we really are going to get a recovery, then we could be losing the story here on that tech sector. Watch that closely. Now, we are at the closest point of all the indexes of where we could actually break this trend. So watch that. If that were to start slipping lower, that could really shake the market just a little bit and push us down. But right now, notice that we're holding on in this little support area of the chart. We have a little support area right below that to hold. So it may not be that big a deal unless we get pretty significant selling there in the NASDAQ. Just something to keep an eye on and be watchful of. Then let's take a look at IWM. Now, IWM made a new record high yesterday. So popping up, making that new record high, held it into the close. Now we're seeing just a little bit of pullback here this morning. Nothing terrible going on in this chart, other than the fact that I think this is a little bit on the parabolic side. When we pull this back, this and take a look at this chart as a whole, we are pretty much running straight up here in this chart. Now, this has been enjoying a tremendous run in the financial sector, and today we're going to start getting those bank earnings and seeing if those banks can produce earnings enough to support those prices. And this has also enjoyed one heck of a move in the energy sector as well. So we'll just want to keep an eye on those. A lot of those stocks are very, very extended, and it wouldn't be a surprise to see some profit taking come in at any time. So watch that close. Let's take a look at our VIX. Our VIX, interestingly enough, is struggling here to break this little uptrend. Now, that's unfortunate. We keep pushing and pushing and pushing for an upside move, but we're not relieving this stress here on fear in the market. We're holding that little tiny uptrend, and this morning with a little bit of selling that's coming in, looks like we're going to push that a little bit higher this morning, push off of that little support. Now, keep in mind, I continue to repeat this, and I don't think we're going to have any major problem here in fear unless we break above that downtrend and happen to hold it as support. But we'll want to keep an eye on that. If that selling wave comes in, it could really accelerate pretty quickly because we're quite elevated in a lot of stocks. And so you could see if they start to sell, everyone piles in, getting out of the trade, everyone runs for the door at the same time. And that could really create a painful sell-off if that were to occur. But right now, there's no clues to that, just that evidence that the possibility is there. So make sure you're prepared and you're staying flexible and focused. Be careful not to overtrade, particularly heading into a three-day weekend. As we know, anything is possible over a three-day weekend that could move the market around. So just kind of be prepared for that. Then if we take a look at our T2122, our T2122 continues to shout out there's a concern here, and that is that we continue to extend and extend this market, and we're up here in that bearish reversal zone. And we've held this bearish reversal zone for some time now, and at any point in time, we could start to see that profit-taking wave come in the market. And just realize that the point moves, the possible point moves are pretty dramatic if we pull back. Not that it's really going to destroy the trend of the market. it could just be very painful for those kind of getting into stocks at the last minute here. So watch that closely. A pullback down into here would not be a major surprise to me at any point in time. So we'll want to kind of keep an eye on that. And then if we take a look at T2101, which is the absolute market breadth, notice that the breadth continues in this downtrend here in the chart. And although we rallied here recently off of that low, we're not holding up all that well, and we could continue that market breadth decline here, and that would not be productive, I think, for the market. Now, I would expect if we do get a strong selling wave, we will actually see that market breadth increase on that selling wave, and that could break us out up here. So watch that carefully if we kind of accelerate into selling. I'm not suggesting that is going to happen, just that possibility. And because so many stocks are so elevated, you could just see if it does begin, everyone runs for the door at the same time and can create those painful sell-offs. Let's take a look at our economic calendar for today. And our economic calendar is absolutely chock full of data that could move the market around. Notice that today we have got PPI. This will be coming out prior to market open. The PPI report, we've got retail sales coming out. Remember, the last retail sales number was not a favorable number. We showed decline. And if that were to continue, that could certainly begin to weigh on the market. Obviously, jobs data doesn't seem to matter anymore to the market. We had higher unemployment numbers yesterday, and we continued to move on up. Maybe retail would be one of those things if we have a follow-through with retail of a bearish report. Right now, consensus is not suggesting that. So keep in mind, we could actually get that bullish report out of there and help lift the market back up. We also have Empire State Manufacturing. We got the industrial production number at 9:15. Business inventories, consumer sentiment, probably not going to move the market around much on those, but we'll want to keep an eye on that. And also note that we have a Fed speaker to be made aware of here today. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar. Now, our earnings calendar, we are really getting into the nitty-gritty here of these big banks. We've already heard from JP Morgan this morning. JP Morgan, as you can see, pushed down initially, but pushing back up. They apparently beat on earnings today. And it was based on their trading, I guess. So you'll want to keep an eye on that. And we still will hear from, we're still waiting to hear from Citibank. We have PNC Financial today that we'll want to be paying attention to. And we also have WFC. All of these could be potential market moving reports. So keep a close eye on that and just realize that these have all enjoyed a massive upside rally the last couple of months. So if they happen to disappoint, we could see some punishment coming in there. Let's kind of keep our fingers crossed that they don't disappoint this market. So watch that close. Then let's take a look at some stocks that could be setting up. But before we do that, guys, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, if you could please do me a favor and click that subscribe button on YouTube and also click that bell icon when it pops up so that you can be notified every time I post one of these videos. And if you feel that these videos are helpful, if you could please click that thumbs up button, leave a brief comment. I truly, truly appreciate it, guys, when you do that. And honestly, every day, you guys, your kindness is amazing to me. I truly appreciate it. Thank you so much. Also, if you think that the video is worth sharing out there, please feel free to any of the videos on the Right Way Options site, feel free to share them out there on your social media platform. That helps us gain more eyeballs and more folks to the channel, and I just want to say thank you so much for that. You guys are awesome. So let's take a look at these stocks that could be setting up. And one of the things I want to remind everyone of is that These are not a recommendation to buy or sell any security. That you have to do your own due diligence. Make sure that any of the charts that I show you in this, you do your own work on it and make sure that it fits your trading risk tolerance and your trading style before making a decision. It's never, ever a good idea to blindly follow someone else's trade idea. So let's take a look at what we've got going on here. I put some alerts yesterday on a few stocks like ATI. Take a look at ATI. Beautiful upside trend in this chart. And now we're getting this little consolidation, kind of like the market overall. And I'm seeing this trend in here, and we're just kind of sliding our way over to that trend. So I'm going to be looking for that next bullish opportunity if that can pop on through to move on up. Now, I do have to recognize the fact that we are also pushing some resistance levels in the chart. I have to recognize that as I plan a trade here, but keep that in mind. We're looking pretty bullish here on ATI, and I wanted to keep an eye on that, so I placed alert on that chart. Let's take a look at IBM. IBM is one of those stocks people go, really, IBM? Haven't heard anybody talk about that forever. But take a look at this. IBM has been pressing and trying to move up, pressing against this really big resistance level in the chart, price resistance level. Now, just imagine if IBM can pop through there and hold above this area. So I'm keeping a close eye on this, and I've placed this entire line I've made turned into an alert. I'm going to watch that closely. Now, keep in mind, I'm probably going to require that stock to pop through and then prove to hold, because you can see we've had these pop-throughs before and was not able to hold that resistance as support. So we need some proof here that we can kind of hold on to it. But one thing I do kind of like is that we're consolidating right underneath this area. We're building pressure on this stock. Now, also pay attention to the fact that this is going to report earnings on 121. So you'll want to consider that if this does pop out in anticipation of that earnings, we could still get that earnings report to disappoint. So watch that closely. Keep an eye on KBR. Now, KBR showing some strength here. As you can see, I alerted on this chart. KBR holding in a nice upside move. Beautiful trend, very consistent in this move. Consolidated over toward the trend, and now we're seeing that bullishness pop in here. Now, keep in mind, this is this morning's candle. This candle here is the pre-market candle. So we're trying to push this up this morning. So keep a close eye on that. KBR might be one to get you some upside move here today. Keeping an eye on PayPal. Now, PayPal has been sliding up this trend. You can see we just kind of move right on up in this area. Now we're just kind of resting out here. We're trying to deal with this price resistance in the chart. So as we continue to rest out here toward that trend, I want to watch for that next opportunity for this to pop on through. Keep in mind, PayPal is a blue sky high up there. So there's no resistance above here in PayPal, and we could just keep moving to the upside. So watch that one closely. Another one that I'm keeping an eye on here is Qualcomm. You can see I alerted here on Qualcomm, and we've been running up this trend, as you can see, We kind of fell apart here a little bit, consolidated, moved over to trend, then moved up and held. And that's one of the patterns that I want to see. If we fail, let me explain that for just a second. If a chart fails through a price support, one of the requirements that I have, if it fails that price support, it must regain that price support and then prove to hold it. And that's exactly what we've done. We've regained this price support, and the stock has proved to hold that, and now we're moving on through. So watch that closely. I wouldn't be at all surprised as we deal with this new level up here that we have to rest a few more days in here, but then we could still see that move on up. So keep an eye on Qualcomm, looking pretty good overall. Couple other places that I want to point out. Take a look at GILD. I mentioned this one yesterday, and you can see GILD breaking that downtrend. This is in a rounded bottom breakout pattern. It's what we call it, hit run candlesticks, right way options. And you can see we broke this finally. This downtrend broke through that resistance, and now we're testing it as support. Now, I'm not going to be too surprised, and I said this yesterday, if this has to continue to rest in here just a little bit to build that little bit of support level in here. But keep an eye on this. If we get 3 or 4 days of rest in here, that could be the perfect setup if you like biotechs for a pop to the upside. Very nice little pattern here to be watching. And last but not least, I want to keep an eye on some of these insurance providers. Allstate continuing to hold in this pattern. It tried to push down a little bit, but notice that we're just kind of holding in here. And as we rest out through this trend, we're just really getting into that point where we could engage that trend and really start moving up. So keep an eye on that chart. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great profits in your trading. Remember, guys, we have a 3-day weekend. Yeehaw, 3 days. So take some time to consider the risks that you carry into this weekend. Remember, a lot can happen over a 3-day weekend. And I want to wish you all the very, very best. Stay safe, and we'll see you right back here, bright and early, Monday morning. Have a great weekend, everyone.